How red I look. So this is very typical of what I look like after I've had a session with Matt. So it's been an hour and a half, an hour of legs and bum, well, mainly bum, and then half an hour of abs, and I feel exhausted. I've got a protein shake, chocolate flavour. I'm now gonna drive into town and go on the sunbed and probably fall asleep. I do feel exhausted today. I think I overdid the sugar this morning. I thought it would be a good idea to eat loads of sugary things that I had left over from the tea party last week. That probably wasn't a very good idea because I had loads of like sugar rushes, and then now I'm having a proper sort of like sugar come down and I feel awful. And yeah, proper red skin. I feel like I've already been, I look like I've already been on the sunbed. And that's about it. I'm going to do a bit of shopping. I'm going to go to Body Shop and buy a some cream, some Factor 50 cream. I might, I've been to Primark, keep that quiet. And then I'm going to just go home. I ordered some bits from Pretty Little Thing this morning. So, and I think I'm going to order a pair of shoes when I get home. That's it. I have a lovely quiet house at the moment. And I'm enjoying it. I've got no TV on, no music, no nothing. Just been watching a bit of YouTube and doing a few errands around the house. You know what it's like. What have I been doing? So, brushes. I had a shed load of brushes. One of my, because in my bathroom I've got like two sinks, and they're meant to be like his and hers, but it ends up being one filled with like brushes and cleaning, and then I just use Derek's. That's just pretty standard. That whenever I've used a brush, I just stick it straight in the sink so I know that I've got to wash it. So I had a shed load of brushes to wash, and I've just re-sort of organised my room, just put a few bits away. All those are summer dresses that I had in sort of like a bag in a cupboard, in like a store cupboard, and I don't know where to put them. I don't know what to do. So at the moment, they live there. They're fine on the stool, they're out the way, it looks tidy, it's fine. This dress here, I'm going to wear tomorrow. I've got a dinner tomorrow, so I'm going to wear this dress. I did buy it a while ago from TK Maxx, and it was $24.99. So I thought that would be really pretty with my nails. It's a lovely colour. I'm going to wear that tomorrow. What else? Let me turn you around. This pile here is a pile of shopping that I need to put in a video. I'm going to do that Saturday when I get back from Wales. And this is a box of products that I bought. So again, that's full of stuff that needs recording. So we're now at Thursday. Haven't videoed much this week, only because Monday and Tuesday, it seems to be every week that Monday and Tuesday I do nothing. Like Monday obviously I do pole, but I don't really do much in the day. I'll either be at home doing worky stuff and housework and stuff, and then by Wednesday onwards it just gets busier and busier and busier. So I'm just sat in my garden, obviously, as you can see, just enjoying a bit of peace and quiet. I'm just drinking my vitamins, and I've taken a load of vitamins as well. The house is empty and the weather is beautiful, so I've had a shower and I've done my hair, and I'm just letting it dry naturally, because as often as possible I like to let my hair dry completely naturally before I do anything with it. So tonight we are off to Leicester for a charity dinner. I've already picked up my dress and I'm just trying to work out shoes and handbag, but I'll show you that later. And then I've packed, because then we're going straight from Leicester driving tonight to Wales to stay at the Celtic. So we'll be at the Celtic till Saturday. So I've moisturised, cleansed my face, moisturised. I'm trying out a new moisturiser, so I'm using the Body Shop SPF 50 Plus from there. I can't remember which range, but I'll show you that when I go upstairs. Oh, I think something's just fallen in my hair. No? So yeah, so I've used the Vichy serum and then the SPF 50 moisturiser, because when I was, after I had my profilo done, I was speaking to the lady who does it about obviously ageing and how to protect your skin, and she said the most important thing was to wear SPF 50 every day. And I thought, you know what, I don't, unless there's sort of a bit of SPF in any moisturisers that I use already, I don't consciously wear an SPF 50 daily, because I think to myself, well, when I go out in the sun, usually my face is covered anyway. I don't sunbathe and have my face out, but then like you say, I'm sat here in the shade. But you're right, right, you know, the damage is being done. So that's what I plan to do now, is wear the SPF 50 every day, regardless of where I'm going and what I'm doing. I've covered myself in baby oil gel, so that when I get dressed later, my skin will already be nice and moisturised. I'm going to go quite glowy, so my dress is very sort of girly. I have all my chest glowing, and I forgot to fake tan last night, which is a right pain, but I'm still quite brown. It's my mum's birthday on Sunday, so I'm planning to do something on Sunday with her. I'm waiting for some deliveries today. So this morning I had my derma roller turn up. I'm not going to use it until maybe Saturday night. So now I've got everything, so I can start my derma rolling treatment. I'm waiting for a Pretty Little Thing package to turn up. Keep waiting for the doorbell to go. And I've ordered some shoes, some more Perspex shoes, but they shouldn't be here till Monday. So if they fit and if I'm happy with them, I'm going to order a couple more.
You do it twice, once with mum without.
Yeah. Okay. So finally ready, and we are on our way to Leicester. I've just been sat doing a few photos because the lighting is lovely. I'm not naked, I have got a dress on. I'll show you. So my makeup, I've gone for really soft pink eyes, soft pink lips. I've tried a new foundation out tonight. I've tried a load of new products, so I don't actually know which thing is making my makeup look so nice, but I've tried a new primer. Different foundation. Yeah, so my first foundation I put on, I didn't really like. It was some tester that I'd got, but it didn't have a name on it, so I've no idea what it was. But I know it would have been something high-end from like Debenhams or House of Fraser. But it was a bit light coverage, so then I covered it with the YSL All Hours foundation, which is lovely. And of course, because it's gone over the same primer, maybe that's what has made it look so glowy. My highlight, which I'm absolutely in love with, is Primark. So a new one that I bought the other day. It's like a pigment. And my eyes, I've used Morphe, a bit of Morphe and Revolution. And then on my lips is MUA. It's like a velvet lip paint. What else? I've also used a new concealer under my eyes, which is the It Cosmetics. Again, I got it in a tester ages ago and never used it. So I've tried that tonight because my under eyes are getting really dry and I'm having issues with like creasiness. And but then also before I put oil on, which is something that I've stopped doing recently, is putting an oil on before I put my makeup. So I've gone back to putting oil on my cheeks and my under eye area. So again, it could be any one of those, but we'll see how this holds out. Setting spray, I've got the Iconic, followed by Morphe. And on my body, I've put some more of the Primark highlighter when I'm somewhere better in the light. And there's my lovely husband looking gorgeous.
I'm not the husband, I'm just a driver.
Yeah, the light's not great, so I'll do a bit more filming when we get there. We've got about an hour's drive, so. So everyone's just about to sit down, and I've come to the ladies just to fill you in. And I wanted to show you my dress, but there's no full length mirrors in here, which is a bit annoying. Let me show you the back. So that's what the back looks like. And then I'll turn you around and show you the front. So that's the front design. And this is from TK Maxx. And then, I don't know how I'm gonna do this. It does go. Oh, And my shoes, see if I can show you my shoes. My shoes have like a hologram effect. So my makeup has held up quite well. We're gonna see how this primer does for the rest of the evening. I'm starving. We've been here for an hour now, just sat in the champagne reception. So luckily everyone's gone to sit down now. And I'm gonna go and sit down. I don't wanna be late. And I will see you all soon.
Most of you in this room, if not all of you, know what a great charity this is, and it's one of the charity that champions really do get behind. And 1.5 million over 10 years is a fantastic, fantastic start. But we want to increase that this evening. So I've got a few lots to go through. I will please ask for the best of order tonight. If you're really loud and I have to keep shushing you, it takes a bit longer. Plus, I've got the brothers outside lifting all the wheels off your car and breaking in. And the quicker we can get over, the quicker you can get out and see what we've stolen. So, we'll crack straight on, ladies and gentlemen. Do you want me to go on the middle stage? I don't mind, I'm okay. I've always got the centre of attention. Well, I'll start here, let's see how we get on. I'll tell you what, no, we'll go over to the middle stage. Is there room on there? Because I know there was the piano on there. Is there room on the middle stage?
£800,
I'm looking for £900, Adrian. 9.5, I'll see the big 1,000, looking for £1,000, 1,000, thank you. Do I see 11? 1,000, I have, looking for 1,100, 1,100, 1,000, I have. Do I see, what's that thing? Oh, 1,000 there, well, don't look around, you're showing me bald spot, but what's that a bit? $1,000 looking for 1,100, and I saw a middle finger there. That's 1,100 to me. £1,000 I've got. Don't miss anything, sir. £1,000 I'm looking for 11. 1,100 I'm looking for. 11 I've got. I see 12. 12. 13? He won't go. 12 I've got looking for 13. 12 I've got looking for 13. 1,200. £1,200 I've got. Then, ladies and gentlemen, we're not going to mess around tonight. £1,200 I've got. £1,200 then for the first time. £1,200 we've got for the bespoke suit. £1,200 then for the second time. £1,300 we've got. 13. Happy boys, brother. Oh, my word, that's not a good. So we've got 13. Then share it. You have the jacket, you have the trousers. Okay. 13 we've got. We see 14. 1,300. 1,300 going once then. £1,300 going for the second time.
I've just left the venue. Derek's just finished his bit of auctioneering and he raised a load of money as always, and we now have a 3-hour drive to Wales to the Celtic Manor, where we will be staying the night, and then staying two nights. We're staying there till Saturday. I'm driving. It was a good evening. It's freezing out here though. I loved my dress. I loved my dress and my makeup. Yeah, still looking all right. So I'm we're walking past the car. So yeah, still happy with my makeup. I don't know what it is. I don't know if it's my new skincare or this new primer or the foundation. I wish I knew what it was, but whatever it is, I like it. And that Primark highlighter, oh my goodness. All right, here goes. Here starts the journey. We've just stopped at a service station about an hour away from Wales to get some supplies. That's all for Derek. And then I'm gonna have a salad.
They're all for me, did you say?
I said they're all for you and I'm gonna have a salad.
Yeah, of course.
And I'm gonna get a hot chocolate.
A salad chocolate?
Yeah. And then carry on with the rest of our journey. An hour to go.
Yeah, it was all lovely and bold. It was good to be here. Hope you all had a good day. I'm going to go to bed. My makeup's lasted. My highlighter's still highlighting.
My highlighter's still highlighting?
Yeah. Is that what you say?
Well, I suppose. But my makeup has lasted really well.
That's what you will say, though, won't you?
No, but I have to, I will.
I know you will.
My eyes being a bit, my eyes look a bit tired and liney. I'll have to cut that bit out. Right, as you've already heard, we've just got to Wales. It took us 2 hours, which wasn't too bad considering I thought it was about 3. And we are now in our lovely room at the Celtic. I'm gonna take some makeup off and we're gonna get into bed. I'm in the bathroom at the moment. It's all quiet. I think we're gonna watch a bit of TV. And then I've got a couple of treatments booked tomorrow. I'm gonna go to the sauna and just enjoy my day while Derek's working. And Derek's having a golf lesson. Say morning, but it's not morning, it's now sort of lunchtime. It's coming up to 1:30 on Friday. I obviously have woken up in Wales, so we were in Leicester yesterday for a dinner, drove to Wales, now woke up, we're at the Celtic Manor, which is in Newport. We've been here so many times, we absolutely love it here. So we're here for, Derek's got a talk today, he's there at the moment. We went down for breakfast this morning. I had far too much food, as I always do. When you're at a hotel, you always have like far too much food, don't you? So I had pancakes and maple syrup and everything. Felt a bit crappy. Then I had a coffee, felt a bit more crappy again. So I've just come back to the, I came back to the room, just chilled, watched a bit of TV. And I'm about to go to the spa. So I've got a facial and a massage booked in. I'm gonna go to the steam room and really enjoy the afternoon. But I just wanted to show you the room we're in. Let me just turn you around. So starting from the front door, this is the wardrobe area. Derek's shoes. Now, this is very typical. Derek is very neat and tidy. He has OCD and he is very, very neat and tidy. So his shoes are like that. And in a minute, I'll show you how my shoes are. Here's the bathroom. So it's all marble. Ooh. Sink. It's me. Shower. And then the bath. Let's go back out.
sleeping area. So, bed with my pillow. As always, Derek's stuff. Very, very neat. Some nibbles that we picked up on the way. There's the TV. And of course, all they're talking about is the royal wedding tomorrow. So here is some of my stuff. Actually, it's not too bad, but that's only because I haven't used much of it. So I've got my toiletries, makeup, jewellery, brushes, some palettes, chocolate. And then, yeah, this is typical of how my shoes are. And my clothes. Derek's clothes are all hanging in the wardrobe. I just shoved mine on the back of the chair. And more shoes down there. Yeah, there you go. So that's my neatness. And we have a little balcony. So let me just show you outside. I can open it with one hand. I'm not too sure. Okay, I'm going to show you the view. It's actually quite a small balcony. Very different to what I had at the Belfry last week. And I have stayed here a few times when I've had a really nice big balcony I've been able to lay out on. But this one's very small and I'm not great with heights, I've got to be honest. So I'm going to go out a little bit, but it's not my favourite thing. So there's more of the hotel and this is the view. So that's the golf course, or part of the golf course, because I think golf courses here are huge. So we're on the 8th floor, so we are actually quite high. And this, all behind these trees, is where the kids' climbing area is, with all the, I don't know what you call it, like the zip wire and stuff, that's all in there. But yeah, the view is beautiful. It's a little bit chilly out here. I'm gonna go back in because I'm feeling a bit, ooh. Yeah. I'm down in the spa. I've just been in the steam room for about 10 minutes. I am going to show you what everything looks like and then I'm going to go next door for my treatments. So this is the jacuzzi, sauna, and steam room. I've just got back from my treatments at the, it's called the Forum Spa at the Celtic. I think this should just be my new job. I just travel the country trying out treatments. Yeah, I should just test out spas all around the country. It was lovely. The lady was called Kate. She did, so I was meant to have a facial. I was meant to have a mini facial and then a full body massage. I changed that to have a more intense facial and a back, neck and shoulder massage, which also included hand and arm massage, a head massage, a neck massage, did I say that? I don't know. And it's really awful because she said, oh, obviously how hard do you want it? And I said, I'm quite hard because I'm used to like sports massages and deep tissue, and she went in, but I had some really bad knots and I really feel really embarrassed, and I've got really bad knots because I think that it's hard for them to work with and I find it a bit uncomfortable as well. And they always say to me, God, you have got a lot of knots, haven't you? And I think, hasn't everybody? It's obviously not. I don't think pole helps. I don't think all the training helps, and they're not getting regular massages. I think that's something I'm going to have to look into. Yeah, I do sort of have quite a bit of tightness around my arms, and maybe that's where all the injuries are coming from. I don't know. And then my face, she said my skin was feeling quite dehydrated, so she put lots of really nice products. Now, at this spa, they use Elemis, so it was all Elemis products. I'm all bunged up now because I'm laying down. So it was all Elemis products. My skin does feel lovely. Really, it really feels really nice. I didn't buy anything because I'm not that amazed with Elemis. But I'm definitely going to look into some more hydrating products, and definitely under my eyes and cheeks and everything. I'm going to look into some more hydrating masks and everything. Yeah, so again, stepping up the skincare. I couldn't be bothered to put any makeup on tonight because my skin is looking really, really nice after my facial. So I've just stuck some lipstick, bit of serum and lipstick. And earrings are Primark.
He's gone.
And I've stuck some bracelets on. And that's it. We're off to dinner with some friends at one of the Celtic Manor restaurants. I think it's a... We have to get a shuttle bus there, so it's a few minutes away. It's not actually in the hotel, but it's in the complex. And they've just messaged to say they're going to be late, so we can just sit back for a little bit now because I didn't have to put loads of makeup on. I'm ready just in time. I could do with the coffee on the way as well.
Oh, there we go. There we go.
Please turn slide left in 300 yards
just
and then
keep
right.
Not yet, maybe an hour.
When I'm good and ready, how's that?
So we've just left the Celtic and we are now on our way back home. It is...
Now turn slide left.
10:15. Blimey. 10:15, we're due home about 12:30. And then I've got a few bits to do in the garden, a few bits to do in the office. It's a lovely day. And I don't even know what day it is today.
It's Saturday.
Oh my god. So yeah, got a few bits to do in the garden and we can start our weekend at home. My dress, I'm wearing a mint dress today because I've still got my nails sort of mint, but they're being changed on Friday just before Milan. So I'm in a nice summer dress today, but I couldn't bother to put any makeup on. From Wales for hours. I've been in town, I've been on the sunbed, I've been to the gardening centre and I've picked up a load more stuff for the garden. I'm not going to show you the whole of the garden, but I will show you what I got today. Hold on. So this area here was empty and as you can see it was just a bare fence and I didn't like it. So my neighbour suggested that I get some bamboo. So that's what that is. I bought two of them. And in the wind, they'll make a really nice rustling sound. I've planted them there and they fill up that space there really nicely. And then, I don't even know what that is, but it has white flowers and that's another one that I've just planted. And then we get out the sun. I have these little pots. So I bought some of these plants to put in. Apparently they're called succulents. And I didn't buy enough of that pot. So I need to buy a couple more for there. This is a bit of my garden. I will do a full tour of my garden. I just want to get those last little plants first. Because I absolutely love it. We're now at the end of the week. It's now Sunday. It's my mum's birthday today, so we're heading off to Peterborough, me and Derek, to take my mum and dad out for lunch. It is an amazing day. The weather is beautiful. And on days like this, I love getting dressed up because
It's so easy to pick an outfit when it's nice weather. Let me go back a bit because that sun is a little bit bright. So these amazing sunglasses are Dior. My dress is H&M. I think my earrings are H&M as well. I'm not too sure. We're going to go out for dinner. I haven't even looked into a restaurant yet, so I hope that we can get in easily. But I quite fancy sitting outside somewhere, so I'll Google some places on the way. So I'm going to pick some flowers up and pick a card up. And that will most likely be my Sunday, and that's the end of the week. And then obviously next week is the countdown to Milan, which this time next week I'll be in Milan.